here with UFC featherweight Calvin Kattar, who just scored a heck of a knockout against Ricardo Lamas in his hometown in Chicago in the first round of UFC 238. But Calvin, first things first, it's not every day that you get to shout out to your mom on ESPN. Were you able to talk to her in the locker room afterwards before coming out here?
She shoot me text and she said she can't wait to give me a hug, kiss. I say, hey, I love you too. And then she keeps texting me like, mom, I got to fight, you know, but nothing's better than that. And I hope tomorrow when I put on ESPN and I see myself on the top 10 with the na-na-na, I can't wait.
Yeah, we'll talk about that finish, obviously, the big right hand. And you've expressed a lot of confidence in your boxing. But can you talk, how did you set up that finish that we saw tonight?
Just work on my coaches, man. We've been practicing that like all the way starting camp. We practice this kind of basic boxing combinations and things, but we do them to the point where it just comes out. And if you're thinking in there, then you're moving too slow. We just try to react, set combinations and muscle, reactions. If you think it in there, you're too slow. So we're trying to set triggers and reactions, and it just came out natural. I didn't even feel like I hit him when it hit. It's like hitting a home run. It's a sweet spot on the bat. Sorry, went down, and I finished it up.
I mean, this is nothing new for you, really. I mean, you've had a lot of success since coming over to the UFC, but this is a big name, and this is a big knockout, potentially that na-na-na moment. Did you feel like you made a statement tonight?
Hell yeah. I'll be checking Twitter all night till those bonuses come out. I can't wait. But Ricardo Lamas, hats off to him in Chicago. Everything went great, almost too great. I felt great being here. Great weather all week. I've never been to Chicago. I've always wanted to come. I hear in St. Paddy's Day they put the river green. I've always just wanted to come here. It felt right to be here. The timing, everything. Ricardo was an opponent, and I got a lot of respect for him, man. I appreciate him giving me the opportunity, and it was great hearing that crowd cheer the way they did. And it wouldn't have been like that if it wasn't for an opponent, formidable opponent like Ricardo.
With that boxing style that you have, who are some fun stylistic matchups? I mean, there's plenty of big fights out there, big names, but because of just how good your boxing looks, who do you think stylistically would be fun matchup?
You see, Max Holloway's his output is crazy. His volume, you saw what he did in his last fight, two fights ago with Ortega. I just can't help it. And then the reach, he's impressive to watch, and an exciting matchup that. You know, you can't help but tip your hat. He's got good hands, man. So, obviously, Poirier did well, but that was jumping up a weight class. I think there's a lot of fun guys in the division with some hands, but I'm ready to take on whoever they line up with me next, man. Like I said, I feel like I heard that there's going to be a Boston card sometime in the near future, and I'd love to headline it.
You spoke real quickly about something in the cage afterwards, that you lost a friend of yours. Is there anything else you can tell us about that loss that you went through before this fight?
Just that it motivated me more than more than I could put into words, and I really couldn't take it in the moment, because that's, man, nothing. There's no fight like life, man. You can go in the cage, it's 15 minutes. You get out, every day is a fight, and I just try to take everything on my plate and put it as a chip on my shoulder and more ammunition to fuel my hard training sessions and really dig deep when it gets tough, because, like I said, you could either get small or get big from that happens to you. But when that happened with my buddy, it really hit me hard. But like, I almost haven't even absorbed it yet. I hope to really reflect on it after this fight. But I had to give him a shout out. I definitely dedicated this fight to him. And just, yeah, anybody that's, I know we're all affected by addiction, people with addiction. And I just hope that if you are one of them, that you seek help, because now the loved ones are the one that are carrying the grief and the pain, when it hurts. So just make the tough decision, if not for yourself, and your loved ones, go seek help.